In this video, you'll learn how to turn your animations into animated tattoos all inside of After Effects, whether they're vector-based motion graphics or frame-by-frame animation. This video went quite viral on TikTok recently, and it inspired me to see if I could recreate some of these elements and textures to create an animated tattoo inside After Effects. Now, this was done by the incredible tattoo artist Phil Berge, who has created many, many animated tattoos. So how does he do it? Well, he finds the original animation and then isolates those elements that he wants to tattoo by copying every frame. Then he prints those to a transfer paper to apply and then tattoo to his patrons. Now, his execution is just fantastic, and I love the idea of getting an animated sequence tattooed on myself or even a single frame from a collaborative project like this. Phil has a ton of examples on his YouTube channels and Instagram. It is really inspiring stuff. So I used his examples as a reference, but really nothing can beat the real thing. So first we need to create our animation. I'm making one with shape layers and After Effects and one that's frame by frame. Then we need to apply all the effects to realistically compose it onto some skin. And you can download these project files for free down in the description. So for the frame by frame animation, I took this lovely looping GIF from The Simpsons of Homer calmly driving. Then I took that into Photoshop to trace over just the line art of the head, making the lines much thicker, which I think adapts it to a tattoo a bit nicer. I used Photoshop with a now unsupported animation plugin called AnimDesign 2, but you could use any frame by frame software, Adobe Animate, Critter, Procreate, or even Blender with a grease pencil. They all work largely the same for this process. So once that was done, I rendered it out as a movie and imported that into After Effects in its own composition. And I also slowed it down by half as well, just so it would match with my skin texture a little better, which you will see a little later. For the vector shape layer tattoo, I created this simple geometric anchor line art design, and I added some simple position animations and trim paths to get it to reveal on and disappear again. But you can take a deeper look at these if you want to find out more about that. They are all within the project file in the description. But before we apply and composite this onto our skin, we need to add some effects that will make it a bit more tattoo-y. So let's add a new adjustment layer with Ctrl Alt Y. And let's name that effects, because we always label our layers. First, we need to create a subtle boil. Now, an animated boil is what happens in frame by frame animation where the lines aren't exactly drawn perfectly one frame to another. And adding this boil will make it look a bit more like each frame is a new tattoo executed slightly differently. So first, let's add the effect turbulent displace. Now this will warp our animation, but we don't want it warping anywhere near as much. So let's turn the size down to 50. And the amount way down to about 3. So that is pretty subtle, but if we flick it on and off, we can see there's a slight difference. Great, now we need to get it animated. So we can add the simple expression to the random seed property, which is hiding below evolution options. And random seed is the number that is the basis for the random warping and distortion. So if we change this number, we change the distortion. So we need to animate that. And we can do that by adding a simple expression. So let's Alt or Option click the stopwatch and type in time asterisk 4, which is time multiplied by 4. And what that will do is change the random seed every 4 frames. So now every 4 frames, it looks like a slightly differently drawn anchor. Now to get some more detail and grit into the edge of this, we are going to duplicate that effect again. But this time we are going to increase the amount from 3 way up more to something around 30, but then decrease the size way down to 3. So this now gives some small distortions along the edges of the lines, as well as the big distortions which distort the line itself. And this seems a bit like little imperfections in the tattoo where it has been drawn. Then we're going to give a random shape to the position of each frame. So to do that, we'll add the effect transform, which brings up all our familiar transform properties, position, scale, rotation, etc. And we're going to add a wiggle expression to position. So again, Alt Option click the stopwatch, and we're going to type in wiggle, then in parentheses 12, 2, so it will wiggle 12 times per second up to a maximum of 2 pixels. So now we can see it shifting around a little bit. The last thing we're going to do is add a posterized time effect, and this will lower our frame rate. So I'm going to take it down to 8 frames a second, and let's see how that looks. So this will make it feel not as clean, digital, precise, and just make it feel a little more hand-drawn, which is kind of the look we're after here. And I'm also going to add a bit of texture and shading to mimic an almost stipple technique you find in the shadows of a lot of traditional tattoos. And I'm going to use one of the many noise techniques I explored in my last video. So let's create a new solid with Ctrl or Command Y, and let's make sure this is exactly 50% gray. Let's put that below our effects layer. And then we are going to add the effect noise HLS auto. And let's increase the noise on the lightness up to 100%. So it is very, very noisy. And then we're just going to increase the scale of the layer itself from 100 up to about 350%. So it is much larger. And then set its blending mode from normal to overlay so we can view the layers beneath it. And then we're going to set this layer to preserve underlying transparency, which is in this column here. So now this layer won't be visible on anything that was transparent below it. So it's only visible on our anchor and on our shading. And because we're using noise HLS auto, this noise is animated and we get a nice subtle dancing noisy grain effect. Okay, now time to composite these onto our skin. But first, a quick word about this video sponsor. Walling is a visual workplace to organize all of your work and plan your new project in collaborative walls. It's super simple to use, even for a dummy like me. You can quickly arrange your ideas on a wall and keep everything visually organized. A wall can contain any sort of content, really. Notes, bookmarks, mood boards, anything to visualize the entire context of a project and collaborate more efficiently with your team or clients. Here's a wall that I created to help me track this project, which is the creation of this video that you're currently watching. I started with a brief of what I wanted to include, lots of references for me to refer back to, and this is something that I have open in a browser tab while I'm designing and animating, so I'm not having to look up each of these individually. And I'm also tracking my tasks in this task section. Currently in progress is the recording of this tutorial, which I'm hoping goes well. But once that's done, I'm gonna place it into the done column and start working on the next thing, which is editing the rough cut of this tutorial. Now I find this is the most useful section for me, where I can set out all the steps that I need to do, and it's just really helpful for my process to just keep me on track. And then I've added some additional sections at the bottom here to show the middle stages of these animations for client approval, which in this case is me, so I don't generally need these too much. But it's always great to have your client approving things and keeping that approval somewhere where they can see it, so they're less likely to change their mind. And of course, you can invite your client to the wall to add their own ideas and requirements, or you can just send them a link and they can easily leave comments or any idea on your wall. Walling is free, so if you think this might be as useful to you and your project as it is for me and mine, you've got nothing to lose, so try out walling by clicking the link down in the description. Okay, now for compositing. So I am in a new comp that I've called Tat Main 01 Motion Graphics, and I'm going to drag in a comp that I've called Skin Plates Looped. Now, essentially, this is just a looping texture, and you can see one of the many tutorials I've done about looping textures up here on the right. But instead of paper or watercolor or something like that, this is a texture of some skin freshly shaved for a tattoo. Now, I couldn't really find any photos online of some skin that has just been shaved for a tattoo, but with a tattoo yet to be put on it. So I had to create my own, and yep, I shaved 4 circles into my legs. Ah, the things I do for tutorials. So therefore, unfortunately, limited by my technology, we are stuck with pasty man legs for this example. So next we're going to drag over our tattoo. Let's drag over our anchor first. And now we can see it playing over our skin. And look at that, it looks nothing like a tattoo. But we're going to add a ton of effects to make it look more worn in and really feel like it's ink under the skin. So the first thing we're going to do is add the effect Gaussian blur. And let's blur it a little, maybe to around 6 pixels. So it definitely doesn't have that hard pixel perfect edge. And then let's also add a curves effect. And we're going to select the blue channel and just increase the amount of blue in the dark areas. And that will give the ink a slightly blue tint. And then we're going to set its blending mode from normal to multiply. So we'll see a bit of our skin texture underneath. Let's also change the color of this layer here as well. Let's go to cyan. And then we're going to duplicate this again with Control or Command D. And on our bottom one, we're going to increase the blurriness up to about 20. So it's just a little more softer. And now in the next step, we're really going to make it feel like it is underneath the skin. So we're going to duplicate our skin loops texture with Control Command D, put that at the very top of our effects stack. And then we're also going to duplicate one of our tattoo comps and put that on top as well. But this time I'm going to change this one's color to purple and rename it to add the word matte at the end, because we're going to be using it as an alpha matte for our skin plates loop layer. So on this layer, we're going to select track matte and alpha matte. So now this skin composition is only visible in the areas of this anchor composition, which is now on top of it. So let's set the skin's blending mode from normal to screen, so we can see below it once we darken it in a second, because we only want to see the highlights eventually. And now let's add some effects to it. So first, let's add a curves effect. And let's drag this down to the bottom right. So we're gonna darken everything but the highlights and create a shape something similar to this. Then we're gonna add the good old hue and saturation effect and just drag down the saturation so it is completely black and white. There, now it's starting to look close. Starting to look like a real tattoo. And now we can adjust the curves up here to determine how faded we want this to look. Let's make this one pretty faded. There. Now, one last thing we're gonna do is adjust the blurriness of this mat on top here. So I'm gonna zoom in and I'm gonna start increasing the blurriness up to about 20. Because it's a mat of this highlighted skin layer down here, by blurring this top layer, the edges of that highlight layer are becoming less defined, they're becoming more soft. So at these very edges, we can see a bit more of our darker layer underneath showing through. And I just think this makes it look a little bit more realistic, maybe as if the tattoo is raised slightly or it is just inconsistent where the ink has settled underneath. And there we have our first animator tattoo. But for our frame by frame animated one, I want it to look like it has just been freshly put straight into the skin. So let's duplicate this tat main comp here and rename it. And we are just going to replace the tattoo animation here. So let's select all of our tattoo layers. And then we're gonna hold Alt or Option on a keyboard, grab our second Homer animation and just drag them over the top of these layers. And once we release, it will get replaced. Now this animation is a lot shorter. So let's trim our work area to the end of these layers by pressing N over here. And we can right click and trim comp to work area. There, so now we've got our Homer tattoo animation and all the effects are still in place. But for our newer tattoo, it is gonna be much less faded. So let's take our curves effect from our skin highlight layer at the very top. And let's just add some more contrast and maybe even bump up the brightness in the very shadows, just so it doesn't feel too flat on any of the frames. And we get a bit of a highlight on the left edge as well. There, I think that's feeling much shinier. And we can even tone down the blur as well of our line art as well to make it feel a little bit crisper. There, a little more like fresh ink. Now there would also be some redness around the tattoo. So let's duplicate our blurriest bottom layer. And on the very bottom layer, we are going to add a fill effect and we'll leave that at completely red. Let's increase that blurriness from 15 up to about 25 pixels and then maybe lower its opacity from 100 to maybe 70. There, that feels kind of accurate. And let's also recolor this one to red so we can tell what it is. And let's duplicate this one again. And on the bottom layer, let's increase the blurriness a lot up to 150, but then take its opacity way down to about 30. So there we have two extra layers of red, which are gonna help it feel like new. And there we have a freshly inked tattoo animation. And with this setup and all these effects applied, to update your tattoo, all you need to do is go into any of these tattoo comps and replace this with your animation. So please check out these project files to take a deeper dive into them. They are available for free to download down in the description. If you'd like to learn animation and motion design techniques, I've got a playlist of some of the best tutorials on this channel for you to take a look at. I'll see you in the next one.